Hypotensy and typical antipsychotics. When we talk about typical antipsychotic side effect, so there are some movement disorders, endocrine disorders and sedation. Movement disorders are also called as extrapyramidal side effect because they are caused by blockage of dopamine receptors at nigrostriatal tract. Very important MCQ, you have to remember that why these movement disorders also called as extrapyramidal symptoms happen. The one of the most earliest side effect is acute dystonia. So this is the earliest side effect, extrapyramidal side effect, which is seen. It is sudden contraction of a group of muscles. So what happens, the patient will have torticollis, that is, neck movement, trismus or deviation of eye. The management is generally via IV anticholinergics like benzotropine, promethazine and diphenyl. Also, to prevent acute dystonia, many a times these patients will generally be started with anticholinergics along with the antipsychotics. Then we have got acute akathisia. This is the most common side effect, so many patients will have it. What happens, there is an inner sense of restlessness along with objective observable movement like fidgeting, pacing. So this again is very common. Here the management is through beta blockers. Drug of choice is propranolol. Also anticholinergics and benzodiazepines can be given. Then we have got drug induced Parkinsonism. So here the typical triad of rigidity, bradykinesia and resting tumors are seen. The treatment again is anticholinergic, prophylactic. Anticholinergic can be given to prevent it. Lastly, we have got tardative dyskinesia. Tardative, the word itself means slow. So it is one of the extrapyramidal side effects which develop only after prolonged use of antipsychotics. So here what happens, involuntary movement of tongue like twisting, protrusion, jaw like chewing, lip may spacking, puckering can happen. Movement can be either jerky or slow sinusoidal, that is ethmoid or choreiform movement. Lastly, we have got neuroleptic malignant syndrome. Here, this is one of the potentially fatal side effect of antipsychotic. Here what happens, muscle rigidity happens. So muscle damage is there along with elevated temperature. Because of the muscle damage, we have got increased CPK level, leukocytosis and deranged LFT. Other symptoms may be diaphoresis, tremor, confusion, autonomic disbalance. D2 receptors in the corpus estram causes muscle contraction and hypothalamus causes temperature increase. Management, it's an emergency case, so management is through dantrolene and other dopamine antagonists like amantadine and bromocriptine plus a lot of supportive measures. So this is about neuroleptic malignant syndrome. Let's look at other side effects like endocrine side effect. Now due to blockage of tuberoinfundibular tracts, what happens is there is hyperprolactinemia causing galactorrhea, menstrual disturbances in female and impotence in male. Other side effects may include sedation, orthostatic hypertension and other anticholinergic side effects. So these are the typical side effects.